Hey YouTube, so this is Mahogany Knots, a little quick thing I've been thinking about, and I want you guys to ponder it as well. You all remember way back in the day when we were all like, you know, no perms, or not so much no perms, but coming out with like the natural perm. Y'all remember the Rio? It was supposed to be all natural, and it made all these people's hair fall out. And remember, you know, all of our relaxers have lye, and then there was such thing as no lye. Well, it makes me think about, you know, when a product says there's no this or that in it, you have to know that there's a substitute for it that may be just as damaging as the original ingredient that we call ourselves avoiding or looking out for. For instance, you have a lye relaxer and a no lye relaxer. Does it make it any less a relaxer? Does it make it any less a perm relaxer, whatever you want to call it? Does it not have the same damaging effects, you know, to perhaps your scalp, your hair, or what have you? So, you know, we shouldn't get, you know, confused and caught up in, you know, a product saying it doesn't have something in it, because you have to, excuse me, you have to know that there's a substitute for it. So that brings me to the new hotness right now, which is no sulfate shampoos, which I look out for that myself. But then I started to think, you know, okay, I'm looking out for no sulfate shampoos, but if the shampoo is still lathering and it's still, you know, getting the grease, the grime, the gunk, you know, off my hair, then more than likely there's a substitute for sulfate that may have the same, may have the same effects that the sulfate does. But right now, the industry, you know, products and cosmetic industry knows that everybody's on this no sulfate kick. So then they may be putting in, you know, a product that does the same thing, but because it's a different name or they change the formula just a tad bit, they could still call it no sulfates. And then we're like, good, we're snatching up off the shelves. So saying all that to say, when you look on the ingredients list of a product and there are things that you do not recognize, but the front of the bottle says no sulfates, don't feel uber confident that this product is going to be better for your hair than something that has sulfates in it, because there's some give and take. It's got to be a balance. There's something else they're throwing in there so that they can take out the sulfate, or, you know, remove the sulfates. So just a little thought that I wanted to bring up. So if you are really into using products that are all natural, make sure it's just that, all natural. You recognize, you know, all of the ingredients. Again, only if this is uber important to you. You know, again, on one of my previous videos, I'm like, if it doesn't make my hair fall out, doesn't burn me, doesn't kill me, I'd be all right with a lot of things. But, you know, at the same time, I know a lot of us are looking for that holy grail product that doesn't have any, you know, any ingredients or chemicals in it that may cause damage 20 years down the line that we don't even know about. So just something to think about, and you guys can post comments and let me know what you think. All right, talk to you later. Bye.